Hey guys, this is Binky the Hunter. Yeah, I thought I'd do a Q&A because I get a lot of questions most of the time of new players in the game. And the most asked question is actually, what colors should I buy first? So I thought I'd do a little tutorial on the colors, because that's, yeah, kind of a long story if I want to explain it correctly. So here we go. Yeah, the first thing I think what you should determine to answer this question correctly is what animal or what reserve would you like to hunt the most. Most of you like to hunt deer, of course, and you get that collar already. You get not the grunt collar but the bleat, the other one. You get that for free, so you can call in blacktail deer, whitetail deer, sitka deer and mule deer, so that covers quite a lot. But yeah, then you get to some maps. For example, you would like to hunt White Hart Island the most. White Hart Island is kind of a, that has kind of a lot of species. Let's take an easier one. Let's take Red Feather Falls, for example. That holds deer, whitetail, blacktail deer. It holds Roosevelt elk, moose and black bear. So that's yeah, a bit of a fan favorite map, I think. To get this one complete, you already have the bleat collar, so you can call in the whitetail and the blacktail. But there's also the moose and the Roosevelt elk. I think those two collars. When you buy those two collars, you can hunt every species on this. Well, you can call in. You have all the collars for this map, for example. So that's something I think you should try to achieve as soon as possible. And yeah, one thing else, by the way, before I forget it, the easiest way, of course, to get your money is the missions. A lot of you still don't do a lot of missions, but do your missions. That gets you plenty enough money to buy all callers in no time. So yeah, this map, when you have the callers complete, you would buy the moose caller and the Roosevelt elk caller. Those are two callers that are very nice, because a lot of map hold moose and a lot of maps hold Roosevelt elk, and also the Rocky Mountain elk, they come into to the caller. And here we are looking at Val des Bois, for example. That's just another example that holds alpine ibex. They don't have collars for that. Red deer, there is a collar for that. The red fox, that's also a nice one to buy, because it calls in red fox, arctic fox and coyotes. And there's European rabbit and ptarmigans. They don't have collars. And here there is the same, except there's also brown bear, but they don't have collars either. So for this map, when you want to have the collars, buy the roe deer one, the fox collar and the red deer collar. Then you're all set for this map. You got all the collars you need. But yeah, that's a bit how I would choose what collars to buy first. If I would, yeah, my preference goes to Val des Bois. I would look for the collars I just said first. But if my choice goes to Red Feather Falls, it will be the moose collar and the Roosevelt elk collar. Here we are in the shop looking at the collars, and I started at the bottom because that's easier. That's the one, yeah, everybody gets. When you're a new player, you get this one for free, and that works the same as this one. So I got multiple because, yeah, that's a long story, that doesn't matter. But you get one when you start the game, and it sounds a bit annoying, that's why most people prefer this one. But don't bother in the beginning, it's a waste of 2500 gems when you're a new player. So then here is the elk collar, for example. There's something else about how long they will last and if they respond to it, but I'll show that later. That's very easy to look in a small thing in Hunter Wiki. That's an awesome website, by the way. So the best tutorial I can give you is go and read the entire Hunter Wiki, and you're all up to speed. But yeah, the elk collar. There's also the turkey collar, okay, the pheasant collar, for example. if you like to hunt pheasants, that is not really a help. That is a locator caller. Find and flush those. Doesn't even say it. High chance vocal response from male pheasants only. Attracts none. Ah, wait, here it's stupid me. It says it here. This doesn't attract any pheasants. It only makes male pheasants in the area call out, so you know where they are. So this one I think you should also buy later. Oh, then I'm back at the top again. So yeah, this one you have, that's for most deer species. This goes for two elk species, and elk are on quite a lot of maps, so that's a good one I should buy first. The turkey, yeah, why not, especially this one. Like with the other ones, with the one I show with pheasants, this one also has, like here shown here, a turkey locator caller that only makes them answer your call. So don't buy that at first. This is the only one you need, I think. This one calls them in, so this works the same as this one, and this one just attracts the turkeys to you. This is also a nice one, because like said before, it attracts the coyotes, Arctic fox and red fox, and by the way also the bobcat and the lynx, but a little bit shorter range. I think I'll show that later. I think that's also on Hunter Wiki in the thing I'm gonna show you later anyway. So, but this, yeah, I can say it also, the bobcats and the lynx are attracted for 150 meters by this one. So if they're above that, they don't come. And there's always a chance with all callers, by the way, that an animal will just ignore it. When he's heading to a sleeping zone or something, then he will just ignore your call. So it's no 100% guarantee they will come in, but yeah, it's well over 95%, I'm pretty sure. Then, yeah, this one is a nice one because the coyotes are on several maps. There's Arctic fox on White Rhyme, and there's red fox on Bush Ranges and on Val des Bois, and I think on Hirschfelden too. Yes, on Hirschfelden too. So this is a good one. You can use it on a lot of maps. The moose, yeah, that's on a lot of maps too. I would buy a moose collar. That one also has a big disadvantage. It lasts only 1 minute, so you have to keep calling with that one. But a little more on that later. The hawk squeal is also a nice one. It calls in feral hawks and wild boars. So, and feral hawks are on quite a lot of maps. The red deer caller. If you like to hunt red deer, this is a must have, of course. And they also respond to this, like do the moose and, oops, that was my bad, and elk, but more on that later again. The roe deer. Roe deer are also on quite a lot of maps, and a lot of people of you don't like hunting roe deer. I actually don't mind hunting roe deer because the males come trotting in, but yeah, I made a tutorial on that earlier, so you should go and look that to know what I mean. But I would buy this one too, roe deer caller. Then the mallard and the goose callers and all the duck callers. I wouldn't buy them for now when you're a new player. Later when you're gonna buy your setups with your decoys and stuff, then they're of course a must have, but for now skip it, because that will, an entire setup will cost you 50,000 gems or something. So the turkey locator caller is only a locator, so that's not important. If you like to hunt reindeer on Hemeldal, they're only on Hemeldal, then you should buy this. Only the males come to this, the females completely ignore it, so up to you what you want to do with it. This is just a fancy version of the two on the bottom, the two deer grunt caller, the two deer callers, the grunt and the bleat. But it's just some more expensive, it looks more fancy, it sounds absolutely ridiculous, and it has the same effect as the two on the bottom, so I wouldn't buy that if I were you. This one is only for the wolf, and no, I'm lying by the way, this also calls in female elk. Not sure how, why you should do that. Rather have a bull. Well, there is a competition by the way where you need female elk. The heaviest one scores, counts, so yeah, but this one attracts only the gray wolf on Timber Gold Trails, and all the elk, the Roosevelt elk and the Rocky Mountain elk. Females. So the Roosa deer call. Yeah, if you really want to hunt Pikabin as a new player, you should buy this one, but I don't recommend Pikabin as a new player because it's not very good for your GMs. The missions on there are quite hard compared to the other ones, and the species are hard to get, so I would wait with Pikabin a little bit to advance a little bit more in the game. At least that's my advice. And then we got these three, those are also Geese Callers, so wait with those till you have the setup. Yeah, then before I forget it, there's also this thing, the e-caller. But I should, if you're a new player, I should wait with that a little bit. The one where the Lynx and the Bobcat are kind of nice. I think the one for the Grey Wolf doesn't work that well. I prefer the normal caller, to be honest. If you know how to hunt them with the normal caller, it's easier. You can make them stop in a specific place. And with this one, they keep walking until they're close to it. And then they spook, so also that counts for them. They come towards it, but when they get too close, within a few meters, and they see it, they're gone. So hands with other lures. Okay, but this one, if you buy this one, it's absolutely useless. You'll need to buy one of these two, but you can only buy them once, as you can see when you bought them. Yeah, you can buy more of these, of course. I'm sorry. You can buy more of these, of course. You can put up several, but you can only buy this one for once, and then it's compatible with all the e-collars you have. So yeah, that's it. Okay, the next thing I wanted to show you is just on the Hunter Wiki. That's an awesome site. You should go and look it up anyway. But yeah, here is a list that shows you exactly everything you got to need. You got to know about the callers. Here it says the deer bleat, the deer grunt, and the carved wood. They're right under each other, and you can see they attract mule deer, whitetail deer, sitka deer, and blacktail deer. So, and it also says if they respond to that. Most of the animals in the game, they don't respond to the caller, so they only follow it in, so they follow it. It says that all here. And here, this is also very useful. A lot of people don't know this, but the callers, they have different times they last. Most of them, they last long, or 11 minutes. But some, as you can see here, the elk bugle, for example, only 4 minutes. So yeah, this column is so useful. Calling back within a few seconds with a high probability, and also walking to the call. So they come in, males and females, and they have a big possibility that they respond, and that counts also for the moose and for the red deer. And I think that's all the species that have that. So only those three, they respond to the caller. The other ones, they don't. Hear the reindeer rattle. Average, I have no time here. By the way, one thing else I forget, very important, the moose caller. It's horrible how long it takes. 2 minutes in game, so that's 1 minute in real life. So you have to keep calling this one. That's why I use a lot of moose scent spray when I want to have a moose. I don't get a stiff finger pressing that button all the time. I just put down some scent spray, get it within 150 meters of that, and then the scent spray does its work, and he will come in nicely. So, but this is the shortest one in the game by far. Then this one, and the other ones are all quite a bit longer. I'm not sure what average and long is. Pretty sure this one lasts as long as this one, but I thought, to be honest, this one also takes very long, but by the looks of this, it takes a little bit, it lasts a little bit shorter. And they don't respond, and the males only walk to the call, like I said before. So yeah, this is also a nice thing. Ah, that's in my video, exactly how I explain it in the video. So nice, it's also in here. The males, they come trotting to the call in a slight arc. Yeah, sometimes they make a slight arc. Yeah, and they walk straight but slow to the call. They are very slow, the female. So, but that's what I like about the roe deer. That's why I don't really mind hunting them. When they live in groups on Hemeldal and on Val d'Herbois, you get a call from a female, you just make a call, you wait about 30 meters from the call, and you know within 2 or 3 minutes if there are any males in the group, because they come trotting in. And if nothing comes, you probably get a call again from a female. You know there's only females in the group, so hunting roe deer doesn't take that long when you're looking for males only, so I don't really mind hunting the roe deer. I know a lot of you guys do, but I don't mind. This one walks straight but slow to the call. Yes, okay, average again. It lasts quite long if you ask me, but this one lasts long. Yes. Okay, nice. The wolves don't respond, but the female elk, they do. Wolf trotting to the call, elk cows calling back within a few seconds with a low probability and also walking to the call. Okay. And this one lasts long. Okay, I didn't know that. Funny. So you can call in the elk females long, and the males, of course, only 2 minutes, 4 minutes in game. Then there is the predator caller. It calls in a lot of animals, as you can see. The coyotes, the red fox, the Arctic fox. This is the bobcat. The Eurasian lynx. This is the bobcat. Then they look so alike. Yeah, you see the difference. But coyote strutting straight to the call. The fox mixture of trotting and walking to the call. Yeah, the bigger they are, the longer they take, I would say. Also big female red fox that comes in walking, and yeah, a small one comes in trotting. And this one, small chance of attraction. I think I heard or read somewhere that it's 150 meters that it's possibility you can get it with it, and it lasts long. Okay, then the e-collar. Yeah, that's a different story. I explained that already. Also, it says permanent, so you turn it on or you turn it off. When you got it on, it keeps on attracting as long as you leave it on. Walking slowly to the collar, spooking when very close. Okay, but this is a bit of old side, by the way, because nowadays these ones can also go in this column. The grey wolves are also attracted, but you have to buy the add-on, of course. Then you got the pheasant caller, that's the locator caller. Males only, calling back within a few seconds with a high probability. Not available, so they don't come in. Here you have the turkey locator caller. Same, don't come in. This one, average, yeah, that takes a little bit shorter, I know that, that's true. So what ones, yeah, I have to look that up later. I'm learning things too when I'm looking at this site all the time, so walking straight but slow to the call. Yeah, they can be very slow. Then the ducks, don't use that. There's another duck species. Oh no, that's this one, of course. Yeah, there's this one that attracts all of them. And then there's a god wall. Yes, don't buy all these callers in the beginning where you're a new player, that's for later. So that was it. Okay, then we did all the callers, and there's a story here they put on here. I haven't even read it to be honest. So, but yeah, this is it for this video. I hope this was useful. It was no hunting. It was just a lot of bullshit on my side. But let me know if you like this Q&A thing, and if you have any more questions you like me to go over. And yeah. Hope to see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.